Tim Burton was an animator at Disney.
And my first point, did you know that Tim Burton was a...
Fox was worried about Johnny Depp's image because it was literally going from 21 Jump Street to Edward Scissorhands.
Yeah, no kidding.
So they apparently didn't release any images of the full character before the film was released.
I still think we've been set up.
A lot of people say that this is Johnny Depp's best role. He watched a lot of Charlie Chaplin. The way he expresses emotion on his face and his walk, the way he used his body, he acted. Dude. He acted from head to toe.
Really?
But it also wasn't an easy shoot for him because the costume that he had to wear that leather constantly.
That's when I just remember starting the film and I had to quickly do some stuff and I'm waiting for like talking. And every time I come back, I'm like, oh, it's still credits. Carrying on.
With credits, if they use the word and, you know that that actor has won an Oscar or some award.
That's right.
And they always put them last. So like the last actors are generally
yes.
If they have an and. They had and Vincent Price. And I was like, wait, who's Vincent Price?
So I went
and searched. And I was like, oh, okay, it's this old dude. You know? Vincent Price was Tim Burton's mentor. He really looked up to him because he did a lot of like the early horror films. Last on-screen appearance,
which of course is part of the tragedy,
and his last moment ever on screen is a death scene because he was actually apparently very sickly at the time. He had emphysema and Parkinson's disease.
Darn.
His scenes were cut to a minimum and this was his last cinema film role.
Oh, that's kind of honor
for Tim Burton yeah. What is up?
Hey, how you doing?
This is The Movie Show.
On Active TV.
I'm Sash.
My name is Ryan.
And we are continuing with our Tim Burton marathon, which I am thoroughly enjoying. May I just add that?
Yeah.
Like, I know I probably said this every time we did a director's... I didn't say it every time. But like Tim Burton, I trust Tim Burton as a director.
No, I don't.
You don't?
No, after Edward.
Mm-mm. No, Edward. I trust Tim Burton as a director after reading the quick synopsis of the film.
What did the movie say in Forrest Gump?
Life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what
you're gonna get. But what I'm saying with Tim Burton is, you know that whatever you're gonna get, the costume design is gonna be on point. The set design is going to be, you know, like you can trust him from the perspective of that he's not just going to make a trashy film for the sake of making a trashy. Do you understand? Like, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
And it's going to be some like gothic.
Yeah, definitely.
Gothic.
Some comedy in it. Yeah. Anyway, Edward Scissorhands. Mm. So, Edward Scissorhands, I've known about this film for ages.
Yeah.
Because like, you know, the character Edward Scissorhands is a very distinctive and odd looking character. Like I think most people who haven't watched this movie know about Edward Scissorhands. Is that a thing? No? Yes? Maybe?
Anybody know Edward
Scissorhands?
No.
Okay, no, never mind. It was just me.
What's wrong
I'm
with
clearly
this
that
generation
odd person
today?
That yeah, actually, what's wrong with this generation today?
Yeah.
But I'd never watched it. I think it's because it's, you know, older films, like you don't, yeah, unless someone's like, come, let's go. Yeah, you don't. So, but I loved this movie.
It was good, right?
Not because, okay, the ending wasn't, in fact, the ending, Tim Burton was surprised that the production company I think it was 20th Century Fox. Yes, it was 20th Century Fox because they still did that funny intro in the beginning with the light. You know, the 20th Century Fox, but they made it like gothic.
I think I missed that part.
Okay, never mind. I'm that weird person that takes note of distribution company design. Yeah. Anyway, so he was still surprised that they didn't say to him, no, make it a better, lighter, happier ending. And you know that Tom Cruise auditioned for this role and didn't take it because it didn't have a happy ending. But I'm glad he didn't take
it. Good choice, Tom.
Thank you.
Besides, there were no stunts in this film.
No, actually. Shame. Johnny Depp went through the most ride. So at the time... Johnny Depp, not that type
yeah,
of
thing,
but he still went through the
skydiving.
Physically, he went through the most. So Johnny Depp, before Edward Scissorhands, was back, when, what's his, 19?
1990.
So he wasn't, the only thing Johnny Depp had done before this was 21 Jump Street. It was a series, but he was loved by the ladies of the 80s and the 90s because he was very charming and good looking. And yes, but he had this whole like the 21 Jump Street like like that look was his image.
Kept
yeah.
back and
yeah, like he teenager. So the reason he wanted to do this film was actually because he kind of wanted to break out of that nice. Like teenage heartthrob
good
celebrity
choice.
And so yeah, that's why he went
like you, Johnny
for the
Depp.
Film. But now what's interesting about this film, so the idea for this movie was inspired by a drawing, I don't know what I just said, a drawing that Tim Burton had done when he was a teenager.
And this is what it looks like.
It's not behind us. It's on the...
It's yep. in front of
okay,
us.
There we go. So what the drawing was a, it was a solemn, thin man with long, sharp blades as fingers. And Tim Burton said, and I quote, "Since I like to draw... In fact, I didn't know this. Tim Burton was an animator at Disney in his earlier years."
And my first point, did you know that Tim Burton was a...
Just... I'm dead.
He was a Disney animator.
He was a Disney
which
animator.
Which makes so much sense.
It does make a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he did like drawing. So he said, "Since I like to draw since I was younger, oftentimes images would come up and then they'd stay with you, you being him, and you'd keep drawing them, you still being him. This was a character I sketched a while back." He explains the character represented him as he was a teenager and how the film represents much of the time that he had growing up. He likened growing up in suburbia to a Frankenstein movie where the suburbanites act as the angry villagers. Burton also stated that he was often alone and had trouble retaining friendships. "I get the feeling people just got this urge to want to leave me alone for some reason. I don't know exactly why." So this is kind of like... you know how Steven Spielberg made the movie of himself?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like it was called The Fablemans.
Self-biography.
Which was, yeah, this was kind of like Tim Burton's self-biography.
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
nice,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
self-biography.
Self-biography. Yeah. Self and biography in one.
Mm-hmm. So a biography made by oneself.
Yeah. Nice. That sounded more like a dictionary.
There we go.
Dictionary definition.
Dictionary. Yeah.
I will be very shocked if it is in the dictionary.
And said like that, I'll be very impressed with myself. I'm literally, I walk. No, okay, it's fine.
We should ask ChatGPT. ChatGPT, what is a self-biography?
Self-biography. Yeah. So this film was the first time that Tim Burton and Johnny Depp worked together, and they actually became very good friends after making this film, because they then went on to make many, 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 many,
right.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah. And then Diane West was the mom, right? She was good.
I don't know why, but I loved her expression.
Like, she was so good.
She was so, like, she was just so, so all.
But she was slightly irritating at times because, like, it was like, she was so happy and optimistic that she never did anything.
I loved it.
Except for getting him into her house.
You know, did you realize that even, like, so, I'm sure, I don't know if you're going to mention about the town and about how everybody was just, like, all in, like, clockwork.
Yeah.
And everybody was doing, like what everyone else was doing. And I just felt like she was, like
not.
Like, the odd one out.
Yeah. Yeah, she was cool.
Like, everybody was working. And they were earning, like, they were working for a living.
Well, the moms actually, or the female, the wives weren't working.
Yes.
The wives were all bored
at home. And all the wives
home.
Were sitting at home gossiping.
Yes.
And she was the only one going out and like
selling
her
Ascot product. What was she selling?
I can't remember.
Yeah, anyway.
But
Avon product.
Emma from... What is her name? Yeah.
So I can't remember.
Your Emma visits or whatever. Or
her name
whatever.
Was... Pig.
Pib, yeah.
Pig.
But even like the husband... like I was just like, what a nice family.
Yeah.
What a lovely family.
The dad was slightly like...
No, it was cool.
It was
I loved
cool.
it.
It was, yeah, it was a cool
he's like,
picture.
And he's like, don't worry about them.
Yeah.
Just ignore them. And like how they were so oblivious. I don't know.
Yes, that was, they were oblivious. That's the good, yeah, that's like, a good way to put
like,
it.
Like he's trying to like eat food.
Johnny Depp's, I actually think that a lot of people say that this is Johnny Depp's best role. And I actually, I could agree. Johnny Depp only says 169 words in the entire film.
I'm not shocked.
Yeah. But what he did was, so Johnny Depp, Tim Burton he didn't actually know Johnny Depp. So he didn't know about the whole 21 Jump Street thing. But
wow.
He did, I think Johnny Depp auditioned and Tim Burton then chose him because of that. Fox was worried about Johnny Depp's image. because it was literally going from 21 Jump Street to Edward Scissorhands. So they apparently didn't release any images of the full character before the film was released. But to prepare for the role, Johnny Depp watched silent films or actors who had to act without their voice. So he watched a lot of Charlie Chaplin. And even if you watch, so the way he expresses emotion on his face and his walk, and his whole body, the way he used his body, he acted. He acted from head to toe. He didn't just recite. It was brilliant.
Most of his acting, I felt like the director was like, slow it down. Like, just slow it. Just take your time.
Sure. And then he actually apparently reportedly lost 25 pounds. To prepare for the role of Edward Scissorhands.
Really?
But it also wasn't an easy shoot for him because, first of all, the costume that he had to wear that leather constantly. And they were filming in Florida.
So he still wore it even though he had
And they were filming in Florida and it's hot in Florida. So there was a couple of times where, in fact, there was twice that it was reported that he vomited on set. The first was after the dinner scene. No, when they kept stuffing food into his mouth.
I was just looking at that.
Apparently, after that scene.
It was just on screen, yeah.
He vomited. And then the second time that he reportedly vomited was he had to run. You know when he starts running back home?
Oh, yeah.
And because of the costume and the heat and all, apparently he literally, it took a toll on his body. He puked. And he collapsed also from heat exhaustion due to the extreme temperatures and the leather costume.
Shame,
he really put it all in. And I also read somewhere that he put so much into this role and he didn't think that Tim Burton liked the way he did the character.
Oh, is it?
Because apparently halfway during filming, they were staying somewhere. So all the actors were staying somewhere. And that day, I don't think he was shooting. So he wasn't on set, and there were these two girls that came onto set and knocked on his door, and he thought, oh, they've obviously just found me. So he opened the door and said, hey, would you like an autograph? And they were like, no, we want Tom Hanks. We heard Tom Hanks is here. And he legit thought that he had been replaced by Tom Hanks. And every day from then was waiting. He believed that Tom Hanks was going to show up and replace him. And he thought that Tim Burton didn't actually like his acting.
Oh, is it?
But it wasn't the case. Tim Burton loved his acting.
Shame.
But he did a very, very, very good job.
But you know what? Just looking at that, that for me reflects Johnny Depp as a person. Because he is as weird as he is. Like the characters and stuff that he plays. Obviously from the recent cases and stuff that happened, you know, with what's her face,
Amber Heard,
he's actually an introvert.
Yeah,
he's actually a very quiet kind of person. If you actually look, so even looking at this Edward as a character, I think it worked out very well for him because knowing Johnny Depp as someone who's very quiet and withdrawn. Shame, it sounds like he was actually going through internal drama.
Yeah, like shame,
drama.
He was like, it was going through the most.
And then probably at the point like he was like, no, dude, we loved you. You're so awesome.
Oh my gosh.
I can actually see Edward, you know, that like, you know, kind of thing. Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah.
So Tim Burton did say that he won't make a sequel of this film because he believes that it's in its purest form. Wise man, right?
Wise man.
See why I like Tim Burton.
Yes.
And then this film is actually included among the 1001 movies you must see before you die.
Absolutely.
And I agree with that.
Well, we've seen it.
If you have not watched this movie, please go and watch this movie.
Check.
You need to watch this movie. It's very good. And it's also included among America's Film Institute's 2005 list of 250 movies nominated. Why is this so long?
Very
250 good. Movies nominated for AFI's 100 Years of Film Scores. In other words, I think what they're trying to say is the film score is good. I think that's what was going on there.
Right.
And then I found this very interesting. So in the film, you have Vincent Price. Now, when the credits played...
That dude right there.
Yes, that dude
good
right
timing.
There. Good timing. Look at us. So when the credits in the beginning... So Tim Burton's that type of director that he plays credits in the beginning.
Yeah.
Like old school credits.
Because this has got that kind of...
Yeah. But even in his later... Even if he's doing... Or even think of Miss Peregrine's... He still had the credits in the beginning.
Can't remember the credits on that film.
There were the weird
this one
pictures,
I know.
The scary pictures, the old-fashioned. You don't remember that?
I don't know.
Okay, no, it's fine.
This one, I just remember starting the film and I had to quickly do some stuff and I'm waiting for like talking And every time I come back, I'm like, oh, still credits. Carrying on.
Okay, great. Yeah. Come back. But I saw it said and Vincent Price. Now, with credits, if they use the word and, you know that actor has won an Oscar or some award.
That's right.
So they'll say, you know, like Ryan van der Sand, you know, like Glory Tina and Tabo. Then you know Tabo won because of the and. So at the end of the credits, and they always put them last. So like the last actors are generally if they have an and. If they don't have an and, then they're at the bottom of the
barrel. They usually squish all the characters together. Yeah,
so, but they had and Vincent Price. And I was like, wait, who's Vincent Price? And searched, I was like, oh, okay, it's this old dude, you know, actor, previous generation, or previous generation. And Vincent Price was Tim Burton's, like, one of his major, like, mentors, but he really looked up to him because he did a lot of, like, the early horror films. And so I think, like, Tim Burton really liked him, and it was a huge honor for Tim Burton to actually get him on this film. But This is when it gets slightly sad. So, this was Vincent Price's last on-screen appearance, and his last moment ever on screen is a death scene. Because he was actually apparently very sickly at the time. He had, I think, dementia. I think they said dementia. And there was another sickness that he had. But he was, I think, he's 79. Yeah. And his role was supposed to be larger, but because he had emphysema and Parkinson's disease.
Oh, darn. Yeah. Okay.
So his scenes were cut to a minimum, and this was his last cinema film role.
Oh.
So,
yeah. That's kind of honor for Tim Burton,
yeah. Yeah, it is. Yeah.
You got him at the last time, buddy.
At the right time.
Got him right there.
Yeah. Tim Burton actually says that although this isn't his greatest film, it's his favorite film. And I can see why. This was a very good film.
But he said it was personal as well.
Yeah, it was personal. So, but it was a very good film. The cutting, and Johnny Depp's performance was outstanding.
Really,
like,
good.
Honestly, his performance The storyline in this film it's not a happy story. I'll put it out there, like, straight away.
It's
like
a weird one.
It's like me. Okay, maybe it's like, that's like the storyline. But the acting was very good. And Winona Ryder did a good job.
Yes.
It's very unlike her. Yes. She had to wear a blonde wig. That's not her hair, by the way. And she said she hated it because, like, it was a shame. She apparently was bullied in high school. That's like girls, she got kicked in the bathroom. Like, people took her to the bathroom and, like, yeah. And apparently, after she became famous, she bumped into the girl that bullied her. And this girl that bullied her was like, oh my gosh, Winona Ryder, can I please have an autograph? She was like, don't you remember me? She was like, I don't know if she did. I don't know. But then Winona Ryder was like, I went to this school and you bullied me. And she basically told her to, get lost. In a nice way.
Yeah. Laughs
last.
So,
Winona Ryder was laughing.
So, in other words, no!
Yeah, but that's the reason she actually didn't. She wasn't keen to do this role because she was now playing the person that bullied her. Jenna said, because she wasn't she wasn't popular in school. She was like she preferred wearing guys' clothing. She was the girl. She was basically Winona Ryder. You know what I'm saying? Like the chick from Beetlejuice. Yeah. Although I don't understand, because she had already done Beetlejuice, hadn't she? Maybe it happened before Beetlejuice.
When was Beetlejuice again?
But she was a kid back then. In Beetlejuice, she was a teenager. In Beetlejuice, she was a...
Yeah.
And then also, so the whole time they were filming this, Johnny Depp and Winona Ryder were actually dating. They then went on to get married.
What?
Yeah, they've obviously split since, but...
there you go. Okay.
Yeah, Winona Ryder and... Yeah. Apparently Johnny Depp got Winona Forever tattooed on his foot. And then after they broke up, he changed it to... I don't know what he changed it to. I think he removed the A from Winona, and then don't know how that makes it better, but anyway,
some food type or something.
yeah but it was very cool. Enjoyed it.
Good film, must go see.
Go watch it. It's very good.
For those who are Disney, so I watched this on Disney Plus. Yes, it's there.
Do you know what's crazy though about so, remember last week we spoke about Edward, which was not Edward. Edward is another film that Tim Burton made, which is about an eccentric filmmaker that likes to cross-dress. That is also on Disney+. But I feel like Disney Plus, because of the whole Disney term, should be child friendly-ish. Though they're very not child. Disney's like not child friendly at all. So the fact that that's on Disney Plus is just wild.
Just shows you Disney Plus is not for everyone.
Yeah.
It's not Disney. It's Disney Plus.
Plus. In other words, you need to be plus Disney. As in
all the other ones.
No. All the other people. I thought you were saying, you know, like age.
Oh, yeah.
Like
yeah,
you must
yeah.
be above yeah. the age of Disney plus.
Plus yeah. all the others. Yeah, included that.
Yeah. Anyway, really glad they didn't choose Tom Cruise. No issue against Tom Cruise, but I don't think he would have done this.
Not well. Your place, man.
Yeah.
I'm sure you agree. Yeah, he agrees.
It was, yeah.
Mm.
So this was Edward Scissorhands.
Great film.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hopefully next week we can do Beetlejuice 2. Otherwise it's coming.
Yeah.
But we will continue with our...
We will continue with the
Tim Burton has a lot of movies.
Yeah. There's another a film lot. That we'll see, which we decided we were going to watch it,
yeah.
which is another blast from the past. But I remember watching that film.
I haven't watched that film.
Ah, I watched it so many times when I was small.
Really?
Yeah, it's really good. Really good. So looking forward to that
coming
one.
Coming soon.
Yeah, we're not going
to
tell you.
We shall return to Ryan's childhood.
Mm. Yes. I'm just thinking of some parts of the film. It's going to be great. Looking forward to it. I'm so wow. excited. Really yeah. looking forward to that one. I'm going to watch that one with my kids. Nice. They're going to laugh. And yeah, it's going to be good.
Nice.
Some people are going to be like, I don't know which one they're going to watch. No, you don't.
Comment down below if you think you know which next film you're going to watch.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
But until then.
We'll see you.
The end.